like I should run away. Cause life is hitting me in the face. Hey, hey. But I'm here, and I'll never surrender to fear. Retreat and be defeated, no way. Cause I can't, I can't. Cause I can see it, I'm getting closer. The hardest part of it is almost over. And now I'm stronger, I'm a fighter. And only victory can satisfy this hunger.
I'll never wave my flag, never wave my, I'll never.
Good evening and good evening. Thank you so much for joining me on tonight for Talks with Tonya. I am your host. I am your friend, your sister, your auntie, your niece, Pastor Tonya Nelson Woodruff. And I'm so thankful tonight that you guys join me every Tuesday night and you come, you fellowship, you support, you clap, you cry. I'm thankful for those of you all that are consistently consistent with me every Tuesday at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Talks with Tonya is a conversation where we have real talk. We talk about real issues and we provide real results. And so I'm thankful tonight for the Lord who is truly the head of my life. Without him, I would be like a ship without a sail. But I'm thankful that he keeps me grounded. He keeps me pushing. And he keeps strengthening me to run on and see what the end is going to be. I'm thankful to my husband, Apostle Walter Woodruff, who shares this platform with me. I know that you may not see him on the camera, but he is always someplace in the building. Amen. Thank you. Thank you to each person that consistently lifts my children in prayer, my biological children and my bonus children. And I'm also thankful for my parents, Eugene and Sandra, that birthed me in the earth realm. Speaking of parents, today is my mother Sandra's birthday. So we want to thank you. Yeah, put those. Thanks, Gary. You clap out loud. Today is my mother, Sandra Ann Nelson's birthday. So if you haven't already wished her a happy birthday, run on over to her Facebook page. She does respond. Unlike my dad, he's not that Facebook savvy, but my mom, she will respond back to you. So run on over there and blow her Facebook page up with salutations and greetings. So tonight you and I are going to have a conversation. There's no guest tonight, it's just me. So I am definitely going to make this as brief as possible because I have two Tuesdays to do, tonight and next Tuesday. But program is always subject to change per the Holy Ghost, okay? So this is what LaTonya Rochelle is saying. It's not the Holy Ghost saying that. But this is what I am saying. But if the Lord changes that, we'll be right here until he bless our souls, all right? A few quick announcements while you guys are gathering your cups and your late night snacks. Big announcement tonight. I am so excited about, of course, you know, my businesses. They have been booming. When I say booming, I'm not talking about just, you know, because I'm saying it. I'm talking about the reviews that I've been getting, the feedback that I've been getting. People have been wanting to come on board to be ambassadors because they consistently say the same thing, and that my product is quality. And so because you have asked, I am delivering. Some people say, hey, Pastor, I don't wear lipstick. I wear lip gloss. Well, your prayers have been answered. On the screen, you see a private, this is your personal view, private. You're the first people to see this. Nobody else has seen it but you, from my new lip gloss collection that is dropping tonight. Tonight, my lip gloss. Sultry Slate, there's a pre-sale going on now. For those of you all that want this lip gloss, it's the color that I have on tonight. It is not like my lipsticks. It is a lip gloss, all right? And it keeps your lips consistently poppy and moisturized. So Sultry Slay is the lip gloss that I am dropping tonight. There are six other colors coming, but I'm going to put Sultry Slay out there. Praise God. So that you guys can jump on this pre-sale, all right? It's only $10. As you can see, the bottles are amazing. How I even set this whole lip gloss up, you are going to be pleased. I am the type of person that likes details. And again, I also am very, 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 very much so in the business of quality product. So Sultry Slay, tonight, you can iDrama, you can cash app that $10, I'm sorry, that $12 to iDrama 2020 for your pre-sale. And I can assure you that you're going to be happy with this new lip gloss collection that I am coming out with. But we're starting with Sultry Slay, all right? Also, if you've not registered for the TFN Global Empowerment Lunch, please go to tfnglobalinc.com and register for the luncheon. All of the updates, you know the date has changed to July 17th through the 18th. For those of you all that have missed the announcements, the date was pushed back. So it's not June 16th, but it is July 17th. And it actually is now a conference. So I need you guys to make sure that you are subscribing to our website, subscribing to our TFN Global YouTube page, subscribing to our Facebook page, so that you can be updated with everything that's going on with the ministry. All right? So now that we have the announcements out of the way, we're going to get straight into it. Tonight's topic is entitled The Table of Contents. You may be thinking, what is Pastor Tonya talking about when she says the table of contents? I'm glad that you asked. But before I answer that question, I need those of you all that are on there to share this live now. Don't be selfish. Don't just want it all for yourself. But share. Share this post with about five people. Five is the number of grace. So you are extending it because you want to receive it back. So share this post on the inbox, in the Facebook, in the groups. Share it. So listen, the table of contents is a message that the Lord gave me while we were on with Pastor Broderick the first night, all right? First of all, we thank God for Pastor Broderick and the Transparent Church. If you missed those two Tuesdays with that mighty man of God, shame on you. That man of God brought a word that ignited a fire in my belly. And I have been, when I tell you, enthroned, I've been thrusted. I have just been in a place where I can really see how God is going to equip us to take dominion globally. May not ever get to go to Ghana. May not ever get to go to Egypt. May not ever get to go to Dubai. Hallelujah. But this ministry is going to go there. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. I already feel the Lord stirring me up. Amen. Praise God. So I'm going to try to keep it intact. So let's talk about the table of contents on tonight. When you think of the table of contents, saints of God, we think about it in the format of a book. Okay. When you pick up a book, for those of you all that still read books, because, you know, most of us have an iPad or we just watch it on YouTube. Amen. But for those of you all, amen, that read books, when I used to be an avid book reader, I would go quickly to the table of contents because in my mind, I wanted to know what exactly was going to happen chapter after chapter after chapter. And I would get excited because the introduction would be bomb. And it would let me know what is getting ready to take place. It would set the tone for what's getting ready to take place throughout the book. And so I would read chapter one, and then chapter one would leave me on a cliffhanger. Then I would need to read chapter two, and chapter two would leave me on another cliffhanger, and so on and so on and so on. But the Lord is speaking to us tonight, and he's asking us, what's in your table of contents? What are people reading when they talk to you? What are people seeing when they see you? What are people observing when they look at your book? Your book is supposed to be the pages of the Bible. Hallelujah. You might not believe that because you say, well, Pastor Tonya, I'm not all the way there yet. And the Lord knows my heart, and the Lord is still working on me. That's still a part of your table of contents. Your table of contents, for those of you all that make that statement, is in the chapter called Excuses. Nobody wants to talk to me tonight. Amen. That chapter is called Excuses. So when people look at your book, and they go to the chapter, that chapter is going to be called Excuses. Let's go a step further. So you can use a table of contents, because I did my research here. I'm going to talk to you. All right? I did my research. And so the table of contents can be used for a research paper. It can be used for a report. It can be used for a project, a thesis. It can be used for a PowerPoint presentation. It can also be used, which blessed me, as a template. Now, when we think about templates, we think about something that is going to show us what to do moving forward. It's going to show us how to put blue paint on the wall. It's going to show us how to put a thread in a needle. It's going to show us how to drive a car. Is going to show us and give us some very detailed instructions. And this is what a template states, that you can trust me because I have the information. When there is a table of contents that has a template, the template gives step by step of what to do for that particular content, or for that particular paper, or for that particular project. But as the body of Christ, the question that the Lord is asking tonight is, what does your template say in your book? You say, Pastor Tonya, I'm a work in progress. Then your chapter is Excuses. You say, Pastor Tonya, I'm striving to be Christ-like. Then your chapter, watch this right here, is Trials and Tribulations. You say, Pastor Tonya, I've experienced backsliding and I can't keep my foot consistently in the ground. Then your chapter is Learning to Be a Child to a Father. We have to be careful as the body of Christ that our books, our spiritual books, does not imitate the the Bible. Let's go to the Word of God because nobody wants to believe me. I want you to put up on the screen there, Harold, for me. Amen. Praise God. I want you to go with me to Galatians 2 and 20. And I'm going to show you how the table of contents is important. The Bible says in Galatians 2 and 20, I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but the Christ that lives on the inside of me. I'm crucified with Christ. So let me put a quarter in the meter right there, because in our spiritual books, we have something that's supposed to be selfless. A chapter that says selfless, right? Hallelujah. A chapter that says, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done, because I'm in my season. I'm in the chapter of learning to be selfless. Okay, selfless. So when the Bible says, hallelujah, that I'm crucified with Christ, I'm learning how to be selfless, hallelujah, and not act on my own, because I'm now partnering, nobody's talking, I'm now partnering with God. I'm now partnering with Jehovah. I'm now partnering with Christ, the Christios. I am no longer me, hallelujah, because I am one. Hallelujah. I am one with Christ. So in my chapter, in my table of contents, I am crucified, my flesh. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm in the chapter of my flesh being crucified, because I am no longer acting as Tonya. I'm no longer acting as Eugene and Sandra's daughter. I'm no longer acting, glory to God, like the thug from 6 Mile in Detroit, because now I've crucified myself because I'm one with Christ. That's in the table of contents. And so glory be to God. Hallelujah. So the Bible says, hallelujah, thank you, Lord Jesus, but Christ live on the inside of me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith. This is another part of the table of contents that the saints of God have the world confused on. Glory to God. This chapter right here in our spiritual tables of contents, we have the world confused, because we have put a page in our spiritual book called fear. Oh, I can't get nobody. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We have not been giving the spirit of fear, but somehow, some kind of way, in our table of contents, we inserted a chapter called fear. What is your Bible saying? What are you implicating to a world that's watching you, to a world that's paying attention to you, to your sons, to your daughters, to your nieces, to your nephews? What is your table of contents saying, and what chapter are you on? Are you on the chapter of selfishness? Are you on the chapter of selflessness? Are you on the chapter of faith, or are you on the chapter of fear? Because at the end of the day, you're telling the story. At the end of the day, you're telling your life story. You're telling what happened when I was born in 1976 up into 2021. But my question is, what chapter are you still on? Many of us are up in age, but we're still at chapter one, learning how to be selfless. Many of us are 60 and 70 years old, go to church every Sunday and every Tuesday, yet we're still on the addiction, nobody's talking to me, chapter. And so when people see you, they see cigarettes, they see blunts, they see weed, because you never ever was crucified with Christ. You never magnitude or manifested to the next scripture, the next chapter, which said it's no longer I that live, but the Christ that live on the inside of me. I have a few notes. I'm staying with the scripture. I won't be on this phone because I know it's heavy. Hallelujah. Because even today, I had to check myself. I said, how in the world? How in the ham and cheese? You're getting ready to do a whole talk show tonight about table of contents and you're frustrated about time. Because I kept saying, Lord, I'm working. I got this to do, that to do. Something's got to give. Something's got to move. Something's got to shake. And I had to catch myself that I did not open up the chapter of complaining. Nobody's talking to me. If we be real, that's why we're talking tonight. If we have real talk, we have chapters of complaining. When God has given you everything you asked Him for, you asked Him for the increase. You asked Him for the expansion. Then the minute He gave it to you, start going back to that chapter called complaining. Yes, we do. I know some of y'all don't like it because it's real talk. And it's a real issue. And the Word of God comes to give you a real result to be free and whole. So I did a little more research here because I'm still going to talk to you. All right? So the table of contents is a format that tells either a chronological point, meaning time, numbers, and then another table of contents is at the end. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. At the end of the story. My God. Hallelujah. In other words, it's a recap. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And so at the beginning we have, I was born this year. Oh my God. In my table of contents. Hallelujah. Whether I was born in a two-family home, single-family home, amen, one mom, one dad, I was adopted, I was, whatever the circumstances is, that begins your table of contents. And the chapters go on and on and on from there. And so you have a full dissertation, a full book already written before you even come into knowing who you really are. That's in the table of contents. I'm going somewhere. And so when you come into the knowledge of who you are, at this point, the chapters in your book should shift. This is the reason why the Bible says, when I was old, when I was young, I talked and I spoke like a child. Now that I'm old, I have a little bit more wisdom. My speech is different. You want to know why? Because the chapters changed in my table of contents. Liken unto when you come into the knowledge of who you are in God. When you fully accept that it's no longer I that live, that the Christ that live in me, then you don't have to cuss people out anymore. Because that was in your table of contents when you was a child. Ooh, glory to God. You no longer have to respond in violence. Come on over here. Amen. Glory to God. You know those of us, amen, that didn't mind having that wish factor. I put my own hand up. Nobody is talking to me. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. See, I don't have nobody want to be real because they still will cut somebody and slap you at the same time. But those of us that are holding on to the horns of the chapter of deliverance, y'all know who I'm talking to. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That chapter was a part of the BC, the before Christ. And so you have now a new you. The old man has passed away. Behold, the new. Let's go to the Word of God. Let's go to the Word of God. Let's go here to 2 Corinthians 5 and 17. The Bible says this. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. In other words, hallelujah, that chapters or those chapters have now closed. That's the old man. Hey, glory be to God. Because remember, 2 Corinthians said that we're crucified in him, meaning that person died. I'm going somewhere. Hallelujah. I'm trying to stay within my time frame, so I can be back on next week. Amen. Praise God. That man died. So those chapters close. I got a question. Why, if God closed the chapters of that book and ended that part of the table of contents, why are you trying to reopen it? Why you want to go back to the old man? When the Bible says, if anyone is in Christ, they're new. What person, Harold, would not want the new pair of shoes opposed to the old ones? You know, the old ones that's run down, have holes in it, out of date. You know, I used to have like a pair of shoes called Ewings. And I also liked another pair of shoes where you pump the basketball up. Mm-hmm. Ewings. Nobody's talking to me. I also like the old school Felis that you change the Velcro around the ankle. Yes, I love those vintage shoes, but they now have new Felis. They now have the new Ewings. They have the new Jordans. That's the reason why the lines be wrapped all around, because even they don't want the old. Oh my God, they want the new. So if the world can embrace the new, why you still want the old when that man has died? Yeah, I know that we got resurrection power, but some stuff need to stay dead. Some stuff don't need to be resurrected. That's why it died. That's why the Bible says that the old man has died. He's been crucified with Christ. And now there's a new one. Meaning that that table of contents in that chapter closed. So here we are. We are at the table of contents with fear. That old man died when you came one in Christ. We are the table, reopening the table of contents of strife and envy. That old man died when you became one in Christ. We're reopening chapters, hallelujah, of childhood trauma when that old man, that old woman died. You're new. So what book are people, what books are people reading when they see you? Are they reading the old or are they reading the new? That's the question that God is asking us tonight. That's what the Father is asking us tonight. Because many of us are misrepresenting the Bible. Oh my God. Many of us are misrepresenting the word of God. When it says, I'm crucified. Crucifixion means death. But that old man still here. Crucifixion, hallelujah, meaning I voluntarily surrendered my will, my way, for a new way. I turned in my driver's license and I jumped on the passenger side. If any woman, if any child be in Christ, they are a new creature. What's your table of contents saying, saints? What are people reading? What are people seeing? What are people hearing from your book? Your life book? Are they saying that, ooh, child, I know that was God because I know how she used to be. I know how he used to be. I know how they used to be. Or are they saying, child, that's the same old person. Ain't nothing changed. Ain't nothing new. That's the same old deal. That's the same old heart. That's the same. What are people seeing from your table of contents? It hit me, Harold, because I'm telling you, I was getting ready to start complaining because I was looking at how it seems like the days are far spent. Hmm. And I don't have enough time in a day to do what I need to do. But I'm the one that asked God for the expansion. I'm the one that asked God for the increase. I'm the one that asked God to give me more to do for him. So the God of time, you mean to tell me not going to make time? Not going to give me the time? Not going to give me the space to do what I need to do for him? That's that complaining chapter trying to come up in my new table of contents. This is part one. We're going to deal more with the table of contents on next week. But I didn't want to get too far into it, and I don't want to go too far off in it, because I know that we only can absorb so much. I think my husband said that the attention span is only like 30 minutes. Truth be told, some of us that have that high attention span, you left me 10 minutes ago. But thank God for those that held on, amen. But I'm going to deal more with this on next week. And we're going to get our minds, body, soul, spirits delivered from that old man trying to resurrect that old table of contents. Let us pray. Father, we thank you tonight for those that have received, those that have heard your voice through your holy word, that we're no longer, it's no longer I that live, but it's the Christ that live on the inside of us. I thank you, God, for those that know that the old man has been trying to rise up. And I thank you that the word of God has crushed and destroyed that old man, and those chapters and that table of contents will remain closed. Father, I decree, and I declare that those that are listening to me tonight will be reminded that they are new creature in you, and that the old man has passed away. Father, I give you glory, and I thank you, because you have done it again. You've snatched, you've saved, you've delivered, you've healed, and you set free the captive away from bondage. And we give you glory for it. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have settled it, and it is so. In Jesus' name. Amen. Again, I'm thankful tonight. I know, I can hear our Messiah. I hear somebody in the Holy Ghost saying, give us more, give us more, give us more, give us more, give us more. But listen, I can assure you that next week, part two, we all going to be on the altar. We all going to be on the altar, because I had to hit the altar myself today. Because I'm telling you, I began to complain. I had to be reminded that I'm talking about the table of contents. And I don't want that old man to try and rise up to make what people think, see, and hear about me be a lie. You have to be careful. The enemy not only is after your body, but he's after your testimony. I'm going to say that again. Amen. Glory to God. The enemy is not only after your body. He's not only after your money. He's not only after your relationship. He's after your testimony. He would rather you, like he tried to pressure Job, curse him and die. He would rather you say there is no God. He would, because guess what? He wants to add to his hell party. The Bible says that hell is expanding daily. So the minute you deny him, that's your one-way ticket straight to hell in a handbasket. Because the Bible said, if you deny me on the earth, then I'm going to deny you in heaven towards my Father. So the enemy wants your testimony. Tell somebody the enemy won't have it. He won't steal my testimony. He won't let God be true and every man be a liar. Let God be true and every man be a liar. Thank you tonight for being a part of this table of contents series. This is part one. As you can see, I was very cool in the cucumber. You know, I normally have already turned up, but I'm telling you, I had to literally settle and I had to keep myself from my soul English, because I feel the Holy Ghost stretching out of Abasia, because somebody's mind had been tormented by the old man, Elabakosia, and you were getting ready to retaliate. I hear God. But the word of God just destroyed your plan, to bust out the windows out the car. You, hey, my God, the Lord, because see, the enemy put the thought in your mind because you've done that before. See, that's in the table of contents of the old man. But the word of God just destroyed it. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. Somebody was going to slash someone's tires. Somebody was going to retaliate by telling something that they weren't supposed to tell. Hey, but the word of God destroyed that plan because that's the old man in the table of contents. And that chapter is closed. It's closed. Yeah, I know they did you wrong. I know that they hurt you. Come on, see, yes, God. I know that you feel like it's taking too long and the word karma haven't hit them yet. But the Bible says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever man sow, he going to have to reap it. And then he also said, if they are adversary against you, they are adversary against him. You don't have to worry about it. God got you. Don't you bust out a window. I don't care what Jasmine Sullivan said. Don't you bust nobody windows out there, God. And don't slash no tires. And don't retaliate with words. Hallelujah. Because I hear the Holy Ghost say your words have power. And so whatever you speak, it's going to happen. Y'all don't believe that, do y'all? This is the reason why we quote the scripture backwards. When we say life and death is in the power of the tongue. Death in life. See, the first thing we say out our mouths are condemning things. Uh-huh. Because we're upset. So I just hope you die. Now, what if they died? How would you feel? I wish you was dead. What if they died? How would you feel? So be careful with your words. That's the old man. Ask God to continue to bridle your tongue. Ask God to give you the tongue of the learned. And ask God to give you, we don't like this prayer here. Practice the anointing of the hush. There's a scripture in the Bible that tells you to just hush. I know it was hard for me to grasp it as well. Praise God. But somebody showed me the scriptures and I couldn't do nothing but what? Hush. All right. Don't forget about the pre-sale for the new lip gloss. Subtle, sultry slay. The pre-sale picture is on the screen. That is actually a picture of the lip gloss. It is definitely one that I am very, I mean, I'm proud of all my lipstick. I'm proud of all my business. But that one, I had to go back and forth about how I wanted the containers to be because I didn't want it to be like everybody else's. I wanted it to be different. So the pre-sale is going on now. If you would like to have one of those, you can cash app iDrama 2020. And I will make sure that I add you to the pre-sale list. The manufacturer is making them now. So please don't message me in 3 days and say, hey, I haven't received my lip gloss. That's the old man of can't trust nobody. See? But pre-sale is your pre-selling, your pre-ordering. All right? And so it has to be manufactured and then shipped on over to the U.S., okay? So thank you again tonight for all of you all that are here with us. Don't forget to join me next Tuesday for part two of the Table of Contents. And as we always say here on Talks with Tonya, in case no one tells you today that you're blessed when you hear the Word of God and when you keep it. Don't forget, we have prayer this Thursday at 5 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Oh, listen, first of all, let me tell y'all about global prayer. The praise reports that have been coming in have been, they've been, just crazy. But again, it's what we pray for. The manifestation of it is happening and happened. And it's going to continue to happen because we trust God. Because we're in our new chapter called Suddenly. But I'm going to deal with that next week. Tune in next week for Talks with Tonya. I look forward to seeing you guys in prayer on Thursday at 5 a.m. and Friday at 5 a.m. And I also look forward to seeing you guys next Tuesday. Take care and have a wonderful evening. God bless.